Thornberry, part of your average family. I got a dad, a mom, and a sister. There is Donnie. We found him. And Darwin? He found us. Oh yeah, about our house. It moves. Because we travel all over the world. You see, my dad hosts his nature show, and my mom shoots it. Okay, but we're not that average. And between you and me, something amazing happened. And now I can talk to animals. It's really cool, but totally secret. And you know what? Life's never been the same.
Hi, I'm Eliza Thornberry, and I have a secret. Don't tell anyone. I can talk to animals. And this is my dog, my greyhound, Darwin. We used to have a chimpanzee named Darwin, but he ran away, so we rescued an old racing greyhound. We can talk to each other.
Hi.
Hi, Darwin.
How are you?
Hey, remember your racing days?
Oh yeah, back in my days, I used to be the fastest greyhound.
Are you ever gonna go back to that?
I don't know, I'm so lazy. Maybe we should watch the videos. Maybe I can get back in the swing of things.
Totally. We should train you to get back in the groove.
Oh, yeah.
Go, Darwin, go! Wow, you're so fast, even though you're retired. You're all the way up to 70 miles per hour.
Eliza, come get in the combi. Let's go to Africa.
Coming, Dad.
So, Dad, what animal are we going to film today?
Wow, Eliza. We are going to go film the cheetah in Africa.
Wow, cheetahs are really fast runners.
Yeah. We can compare the cheetah's running to your pet greyhound Darwin.
Wow, that sounds like an awesome idea.
Maybe they can even have a race.
That would be so cool.
All right.
I wonder who will win.
I wonder too. Well, we're on our way in our combi. In the Sahara Desert in Africa, trying to look for a cheetah. We are trying to see one run so fast. The reason that the cheetah runs so fast is because it needs to outrun its prey. Sometimes they get away. Here, let's look around. Oh, look, there's one there.
Here is the cheetah stalking its prey. Cheetah bends its spine to store elastic energy, simply smashing. Observe how much weight the cheetah puts on its hind limbs in order to free up its front limbs to fully attack.
For the cheetah.
So yeah, we should totally find a cheetah for you to race.
Race? I don't know about that. Cheetahs are pretty fast.
Yeah, but so were you. Tell me, what were the things that made you so fast back in your racing days?
Well, Back in my day, I increased my speed by keeping my frequency kind of constant as I ran faster, but I increased my stride length.
Oh, okay.
And then, I'm kind of heavy, so I support 62% of my body weight on my hind limbs.
Oh, wow.
Yep. I also increased my swing time as I got faster.
Oh, nice.
Yes.
That sounds like a great method to win. But we should go interview the cheetah and ask how they run so that maybe you can have an advantage in training.
That's a good idea. Let's find the cheetah.
Oh, look! There's one. Excuse me, cheetah?
Hi.
Yeah, don't be surprised. I can talk to animals.
Well, I've never talked to a human before.
Cool. Well, I want to talk to you about racing because, you know, you're such a fast runner. Tell me, what's your secret?
Well, it's funny you should ask. I've evolved to run so fast in order to catch all my prey. I put 70% of my body weight on my hind limbs
70%.
At my top speed. I increase my stride frequency and my stride length. And I decrease my stride swing time.
Oh, okay. All right, wow. Well, anyway, I have a greyhound that wants to race you.
Oh.
So,
okay.
We'll give each
other. I'm gonna win. Wow.
Yeah, well, let's take some time to train, but we'll meet you at 3:00.
You got it, Darwin. Just make sure you increase your stride length and stride frequency. Try and put more weight on your hind limbs. Go on, boy. You want the ball? You want the ball? Go get it! Go get it! Good boy!
On your mark, get set, go! Here we are. It's 3:00 on the dot, and they've started the race. I wonder who's going to get here first. Both at top speeds. Oh, and it looks like the cheetah is just slightly faster than Darwin.
I'm the best runner in the animal kingdom.
Don't worry, Darwin. It's okay.
Sorry you lost, Darwin.
Well, I mean, I don't feel that bad. I've been artificially selected, so I don't have to run around chasing prey all day. I can just sit down and be a lazy dog all I want.
That's so true. You want a bone?
Yeah!